Welcome back to Here to Motivate, where we will learn how to quit addiction easily. In my last video, I've shared why alcohol does not help you sleep, it ruins your sleep. So it has been a common myth for a very long time among drinkers that alcohol helps you sleep and that's why you drink alcohol. It's one of the reasons why you drink alcohol at night, because it helps you sleep, but it actually does not. It ruins your sleep. So if you haven't watched that video, I would request you to please watch that video. I'll paste the link on the I button. Now, if you have to quit addiction, you have to change your perspective, and that is the only way, that is the only easy ways. I'm talking about the easy ways of quitting addiction. So the only easy way is to change your perspective, means to look at your addiction from a different angle altogether. Like you have certain beliefs, certain perspective towards your drinking habit, towards your smoking habit, or towards any addiction that you currently have. So you have to look at the addiction from a different perspective. Like I'm sharing a perspective, right? So this is a different perspective for you. If it is different, try to understand this perspective and try to find out more facts about this perspective. So here on this channel, what I'm doing is just sharing my perspective. And if you have learned any other things, like any difficult things in life, you had to understand someone else's perspective for you to learn that thing better. Anything in life that you have done, you have learned it from other person's perspective, and that's when you were able to learn those things. And quitting addiction is nothing different. You have to learn different perspective than the perspective you currently have, which is causing you this problem, right? You're not able to quit, you're continuing with drinking, you're continuing with smoking, because you have certain perspective and you don't want to change it, right? So change your perspective, learn different things. So in today's video, I'm going to share another hidden fact. It was hidden from me, and I understand your pain, because I know I can vouch for you that you also don't know this fact that I'm going to share in today's video. So please watch till the end. Now, the fact is, alcohol causes dehydration. We all know what dehydration means. The average human body consists of 70% water, and it's a similar characteristic like the planet Earth, because we are just a part of planet Earth. Like it has 70% of water, and our human body has about 70 to 75% water. And the brain controls certain percentage of that water and keeps it as a reserve for sudden use. Like if you are working out, then it will release sweat as to keep your body temperature balanced, right? And, or if you are in difficult situation, it will again release sweat to release you from stress momentarily, right? So there are different use cases, like to maintain your body temperature, and for certain use cases, your brain controls certain percentage of water and keeps it as reserve. Now, when that reserve goes out of the system, it will cause dehydration. Like if you are in the sun, if you are out in the sun for a long time and you haven't had a chance to drink water, you would feel dehydration. Your mouth will get dry, and you would feel headache, and you'd feel thirsty, right? That's when the thirst mechanism will kick in. Whenever there is a dehydration, you will feel thirsty, right? And then you would go and get water, and then you drink, and then your water level will then again come back to normal, and then you will be hydrated, right? That's how the dehydration and hydration works, right? The thirst mechanism will help you to identify when you are dehydrated. So you have a thirst mechanism, right? So think about it. When do you feel thirsty? When there is the water level is not up to the mark, your brain will give that signal to you that now drink water. And that's the thirst mechanism, right? So alcohol messes with that. Alcohol messes with that whole system of the thirst mechanism. How? I'm going to share in today's video. Now let's look at this hypothetical scenario where a person is 100% hydrated, like he does not need any water, he's all completely hydrated, right? And then he started drinking, right? Now apart from the fact that alcohol is also a liquid, so it has to be urinated out after you drink, because that's extra water, because the person is already hydrated. And then he's taking more liquid in terms of in form of alcohol. So it has to be urinated out, right? Now, when the alcohol gets into our system, it recalibrates the water system. And when you started urinating after drinking, say few alcoholic drinks, some of the water reserve will also get expelled while urinating out the liquid, the alcohol, right? This is the reason why we urinate continuously after drinking. And we are not only urinating out the alcohol, we are also urinating out the water level. It messes with the whole reserve system that your body has. So while you're drinking, you're also losing out the water from your system, right? And interestingly, your brain will be under impression that you are completely hydrated and you don't need any water, because you were hydrated before you started drinking. And it will stay under that impression that your body is fully hydrated, though it is continuously losing water while urinating out the alcohol. Your brain will not be able to identify that you're also losing out the actual water from the reserve of your body. That's the reason why when you wake up in the middle of the night, you feel thirsty as crazy. And that is another reason why your sleep gets fragmented, because you feel thirsty and you have to wake up in the middle of the night to complete your thirst, because your body, your brain will be under impression that your body is completely hydrated until the alcohol effect wears off. And when it wears off, your thirst mechanism will kick in and then it will ask for more water, and then you'll have to wake up in the middle of the night because you are all dehydrated. And dehydration causes headache, nausea, and so many other things. If you don't know what is dehydration, I would highly recommend that please understand it. And your body is completely dehydrated while the time you are drinking. Now, after this fact, you might try to drink water after drinking heavily, or after your drinking session, you might try to kind of refill the water, but your brain will still under that impression that your body has, you know, it is completely hydrated. Because see, you can consciously try to do things. Like, can you consciously maintain your digestive system? So if you cannot, then how do you think that you can consciously manage the thirst mechanism? It cannot be done consciously, or it is all been done subconsciously, and you can do nothing about it. You only have to quit alcohol for you to get out of this situation. If you're drinking alcohol, and since you know this fact, you'll try to, you know, fill in more water, but then it will cause you more problem, because then your body is fully hydrated, because it thinks it is fully hydrated. So your brain will try to urinate the excess amount of water through urination, right? So, you know, you have to wake up in the middle of the night more frequently for urination, and it will hamper your sleep more. It is already damaging your sleep, and you have to wake up in the middle of the night for urination. Your sleep gets damaged again, and it is not having a proper REM cycle sleep, and now you cannot even have a proper deep sleep mode because of urination, because your body needs to urinate out that water because it is under impression that it is completely hydrated. And when the body is completely hydrated, any amount of excess water has to be urinated out. So this is how alcohol is causing dehydration. So whenever you're drinking, you're causing yourself dehydration and you can do nothing about it. The only way to get out of the situation is to quit drinking completely. So these are the facts I think that will help you, because see, when we look at, you know, some long-term disease. Like, we all know that alcohol causes liver damage, right? But I mean, we know that it's a long-term thing. Like, it is not happening right at the moment. It will happen sometime in the future. And you might have seen some of from the internet or from any one of your relatives must have lived, say, 90 years, and that person used to drink heavy, but then still he manages to live 90 years. So you have that belief that you can also do that, right? It's easy. So you would form so many false beliefs around your addiction, and you would not feel that problem is significant. Like, it causes liver damage, but it will not happen with you. You have formed this belief. Or you might think that I will just live for 50, 60 years and it does not matter. I have to live every day of my life. And you find it thrilling to be drinking. So you have so many false beliefs. So that goes without saying. But then when you learn this small fact that each drink, when you consume that alcoholic drink, you know for a fact that it is causing you dehydration, and it will cause sleep deprivation. So these are the facts that helped me quit addiction easily, and I believe it will help you quit addiction easily, because you have to look at addiction in a different perspective. I believe it is helpful for you guys. If you like this content, I would request you to please subscribe to my channel. That it will motivate me a lot, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Thank you. Have a great day.